We find that the brain tends to work with two different systems, and every brain works in both systems. System one is referred to as more intuitive or emotional. It's relatively fast decision making. It's automatic. It's holistic. It's associative type decision making. System two is more calculative and deliberative. It's relatively slow in terms of how we make decisions. It's demanding of our cognitive capacity. We have to think hard about these things. It's more controlled, analytic, and rule-based. An example of this is the concept of how we get people to tell us about their preferences for risk. And the question is the more calculative or the more intuitive measure of risk more accurate? Let me give you an example. In the following example, I'm going to read you this description of a vacation spot. The Stremnaya Road is extremely beautiful with gorgeous mountains, cliffs, and greenery. While the road offers dramatic scenery, it is considered by some the most dangerous road in the world. The combination of extremely narrow roads and tall cliffs could easily result in a deadly accident. And on average, of two vehicles per month fall from the road. The danger of the road, ironically, though, makes it a popular tourist destination starting in the 1990s. Mountain bike enthusiasts in particular have made it a favorite destination for downhill biking. So the question is, would you be interested in taking an all-expenses-paid trip to the Stremnaya Road? This assessment of risk is more calculative. We're simply describing the risks using verbiage and then asking people to vote yes, no, or I'm not sure, would they like to take the trip? The other way is the intuitive approach. And in this approach, you're now starting to see pictures of the Stremnaya Road. And you can see as you go through that the road looks exceedingly dangerous. It's changing the preferences of the respondent, changing dramatically the perception of risk. And we start to now see a very different response. If we ask the same question, we find that in clinical testing that about 10% of those who would take the trip based upon the calculative way of measuring risk are willing to take the trip based upon this more effective intuitive technique. So that's a difference between two different systems of the way the brain is working, and you can imagine how this would affect the investment decision, for example. Whereas people can be told, if you and typically are in columns of information, if you save this percentage of your income, you get this this nest egg at the end of a 30-year period, for example. Whereas if you were to show them pictures of, for example, what kind of housing you could have after 30 years, or you could afford after 30 years, or what kind of lifestyle you have after 30 years, that gives a very different answer in terms of how much people are interested in saving and risking for the future.